tonight we are blessed with a great writer, and I truly mean that.
Actually turn the statement on its head that normally is given to aspiring writers. Normally they're told a writer should write every day. And you say no.
I mean, there are plenty of days. You know, I actually kind of try and have a life in addition to working. But on the days I work, I also put in 16-hour days sometimes. So when I'm working, I'm really working. I revised like crazy. I mean, Golden Grove went through, I figured, something like 130 revisions.
You wrote the last sentence 300 times.
That's right. And the last sentence took me like 3 months.
So are you a perfectionist or are you crazy?
Are those two things mutually exclusive?
A lot of those early books do concern miracles and spirituality in a way that you seem to poo-poo at this point.
Yeah, I have no interest in it anymore. I mean, you know, you never know what'll happen. I was a child when I started writing. You know, I was like, 24 when I wrote my first novel.
What was I doing at 24? Shoot. Did you have a spiritual crisis and you just figured it out?
No, you know what happened? The 80s happened. Suddenly, you know, my neighborhood was full of homeless people, and I became much more political than I had. You know, I'm much more in the here and now and about social behavior. And the books became much more about the way people act and less about the hope for miracle.
Are you writing for yourself? Are you writing for your critics? Or are you writing for the hungry hearts out there?
I'm sure not writing for the critics, I'll tell you that. Golden Grove in particular, really I wrote for myself in a certain way. I mean, because I was in a state of grief and because I wanted to know what it was like for other people. And you know, we live in a culture in which grief and mourning and the whole subject of death really is so, you know, Americans, we all think we're going to live forever, and we also think that you're supposed to move on with your life after about 5 minutes, and so forth and so on. And that's, of course, not the case. So I was writing a book that I would have wanted to read.
And so you say, like, you've had this new sort of political bent mm-hmm. to the writing.
Golden Grove, in some ways, could hardly be less political.
Right. But After and Bullyville?
After was the most political book. That's a young adult novel. I mean, it's about a high school as police state, this dystopian high school police state. I think a few days after 9/11, I saw John Ashcroft on TV talking about how we were going to have to lose all our freedoms.
Did he phrase it that way?
Basically. And the villain of the novel is this wicked grief and crisis counselor who was based exactly on Ashcroft. I mean, I would watch TV, Ashcroft would talk, I'd go upstairs, put it in the mouth of the grief and crisis counselor.
You have said that writing a novel feels like you get a case of Tourette's syndrome.
Well,
do those,
you know,
two things mesh?
This actually is my least Tourette-y novel. The last, I don't know, three or four novels, and in fact, it's sort of like a part of my life. I feel compelled to talk about the thing that you're not supposed to talk about. I mentioned earlier I had a kind of Tourette's moment with Laura Bush a week ago, because there was a national book festival, which was actually kind of great, in Washington. And I wasn't planning to say anything or do anything, and it was perfectly civilized breakfast. and then we all, the writers, all went out onto the portico and got our pictures taken, and I was standing next to Paul Theroux, the travel writer, and he said, and things were sort of breaking up, and he said, oh, let's go say hi to Mrs. Bush. And I said, okay. So I went up and I heard myself say, I mean, speaking of Tourette's, and it was like an out-of-body moment. I watched myself say, it's so wonderful that you care so much about the children of the United States. It's just too bad you don't care about the children of Iraq.
It started so well. So if people in this, they're all great readers already, but if you could give people here one tip as how to read better, what would that be?
Slow down. Just read what's on the page and pay attention to the word choice and word by word, phrase by phrase, sentence by sentence, line by line.